Hey, what's up? Welcome to another quick edit video with an image from the Dolomites in Italy. This time I'm working on a long exposure, which I want to change into a nicely balanced image with a strong glow effect and rather muted color tones. For the editing, I will be using Adobe Lightroom and maybe the Nik Collection as well. So before I start, let's first take a look at the before and after images. Okay, here we are in Lightroom. Let's go to the lens correction tab first and activate those two settings. Let's go back to the top. And for the profile, I want to browse the different presets here and go with the Artistics 3 profile, which will just turn those green tones into something more of an orange color tone. So let's close this. Now, when we take a look at the histogram, we can see it's a little dark, and I can fix it by simply increasing the exposure. Now, the problem is we are losing details in the clouds because those are very, very bright, so I can fix that by dropping the highlights, and that looks much better. Now, I also want to increase the shadows a little bit, and then increase the whites. Now, looking at the histogram, the exposure seems to be nicely balanced. Of course, the image in reality is a little flat and not that interesting. So let's change that. First, I want to apply a little texture and clarity for some more detail and sharpness. Let's add some vibrance and drop the saturation just a little bit. Now, to fix the contrast of this image, I'm using local adjustments and I want to start with the gradiated filters. You can see I have applied two for the sky part and one for the foreground. So let's work on the sky first. Right now, those clouds are still too bright, so by dropping the exposure, I can fix that. So this gradiated filter mainly affects the left side, while the second gradiated filter will affect the whole sky. And again, I'm dropping the exposure. Also, I want to make those clouds a little more interesting by adding clarity. And I can even add some contrast. Okay, that looks pretty cool already. Then let's also adjust the foreground. Again, I think I need to decrease the exposure here a bit. And I'm adding clarity just to make this a little more interesting here. And I could also increase the texture. All right, then that's it for the gradiated filters. Next, I have applied a few radial filters as well. So let's start working on the center part of the image. This area I want to be a little brighter, so let's boost the exposure. Let's also add some contrast and increase the shadows a little bit. And for some extra sharpness in here, I'm increasing the texture. All right, then let's apply the glow effect. And therefore I have created those two radial filters. So here, of course, I'm increasing the blacks first. Then I can also increase the shadows and maybe reduce the dehaze. And to make everything softer in here, I'm dropping the texture and the clarity. All right, and for the next radial filter, I'm basically doing the same thing. You can see I already have dropped the dehaze. Then let's increase the blacks and increase the shadows. Also, I can drop the texture a bit and the clarity as well. Now you can see this area does look a little bit overexposed, but I think it works quite nice with such kind of glow effects. So I'm not adjusting this. All right, and I think that's pretty much it for the local adjustments. Now let's see, I think I need to crop the image a bit. Okay, then let's do some color grading. In the saturation tab, I want to boost the yellow saturation and instead drop the greens a bit. And also I'm dropping the blue saturation. Then for the split toning, I'm applying a cold color tone for the shadows. And that's pretty much it for the color grading already. Then we can sharpen the image. Then we need to clean up the image since there are a ton of sensor spots. And since I'm not using Photoshop for this edit, I'm using the spot removal tool right here. And then just click on all those dots. I could even activate visualize spot settings, so those sensor spots are easier to see. Alright, that looks much, much better. Now that's pretty much it for the editing in Lightroom. Now since the Nick Collection plugin does work in Lightroom as well, I can take a look and see if there are any nice effects I could add to this image. And in this case, I can apply the classical soft focus effect, which will just apply the streamy look to the image. But of course, I don't want to have it over the whole image, so I need to add a control point right here. And let's place it somewhere around here. And here I'm going with the third soft focus method. Maybe increase the strength a bit. Okay, and that's it for editing this image inside of Lightroom. I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.